Good morning. My name is Amy Morton. I am a proud member of Chicago's Steppenwolf Theater, and welcome to Wintrust Arena. We would like to thank the Chicago Gay Men's Chorus, the Puerto Rican Arts Alliance Latin Music Project Ensemble, and the After School Matters Choir, whose music filled the arena this morning. And now, a ceremony dedication from the Native American Veterans Drummers Group. Thank you.
Well, bonjour, and good morning. Welcome to Ichikagu, which is the original name for Chicago. That is a Potawatomi word that is now, we love to welcome you to Chicago. Today, I'm honored to welcome the First Nations people, the American Indian veterans, including the Ojibwe, the Odawa, the Dakota, Comanche, Lakota, and of course, the Pokagon Band of Potawatomi Indians. Ribbentown, our drum from the Pokagon tribal language and culture, joins us to share these beautiful traditional songs and honor these lands today. Our American Indian veterans of the Trickster Gallery will be carrying in the first flags of these lands, our eagle staffs, which represent our fallen warriors. Those eagle feathers all apply to fallen warriors that have given their lives for these lands. We'd like to get started and ask our Ribbentown drum to bring in our veterans. Oh-ho! Thank you for bringing them in. We will be singing our national anthem, followed by an honor song and a prayer offered by one of our elders, a veteran and a member of the Dakota tribe. If you could please stand and men uncover, this is the first national anthem of these lands. Oh-ho!
Ha!
Thank you. I'd like to introduce, please give him a round of applause. I'd like to offer, introduce Robert Wapahe from the Dakota tribe to offer the prayer for these lands.
Oh, waste. How mitake api. In one of the original 500 languages of this people, I sing to all nations, all of you. And now to Miss Lightfoot. Waka. Oke api. Glory Lightfoot. Ape chehehila. Yep. Waste. Wopila. Waksape. Hey hon. I asked her grandfather, Wakan, to help me Lightfoot. Choose wisely and with a kind heart. And with this, I turn it over to someone.
Okay, we're going to retire our colors. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. The program will begin shortly. Please enjoy the music from the Merritt School of Music. Ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy the music from the Chicago Sinfonietta Project Inclusion.
Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. The ceremony will begin shortly. Please remember to silence all electronic devices, and there will be no flash photography permitted. Ladies and gentlemen, before we begin the 2019 inauguration ceremony for the aldermen and executive officers of the City of Chicago, welcome the members-elect of the 2019 City Council of Chicago. Kindly hold your applause until all the aldermen have reached their seats. David Laspada and Alicia Loche. Michelle Smith and Lee Weber. Brian Hopkins and Colleen Hopkins. Raymond Lopez and Hugo Lopez. Pat Dowell and Wallace Johnson. Edward Burke and Justice Ann Burke. Sophia King and Alan King. Marty Quinn and Beth Quinn. Leslie Hairston and Scott Hairston. George Cardenas and Abby Pirales Cardenas. Roderick Sawyer and Cheryl Sawyer. Patrick Daly Thompson and Kathleen Thompson. Gregory Mitchell and Cleo Mitchell. Susan Sadlewski Garza and Kate Garza. Michelle Harris and John Clark. Deborah Silverstein and Joseph Silverstein. Brendan Riley and Kristen Riley. Rosanna Rodriguez Sanchez and Ava Sanchez Ayala. Derek Curtis and Cherise Curtis. Scott Wagasbach and Jade Lee Chia. Matthew O'Shea and Kara O'Shea. Felix Cardona and Claudia Cardona. Jeanette Taylor and Edamola Aziz. Ariel Roboyas and Ali Roboyas. Howard Brookins Jr. and Ebony Brookins. Chris Taliaferro and Melissa Taliaferro. Michael Rodriguez and Jackie Rodriguez. Walter Burnett Jr. and Darlena Williams Burnett. Sylvana Taberas and Sean Murray. Roberto Maldonado and Roberto Maldonado II. Michael Scott Jr. and Natasha Scott. Brian Cicho Lopez and Laureen Targos. Carrie Austin and Chester Wilson Jr. Anthony Beal and Dana Beal. Carlos Ramirez Rosa and Margarita Rosa. Maria Haddon and Natalia Vera. Gilbert Villegas and Melissa Angelucci. Harry Osterman and Peggy Osterman. Emma Mitz and Oscar Taylor. Matt Martin and Kathleen Martin. Samantha Nugent and Rory Nugent. James Kappelman and Richard Thale. Andre Vasquez and Valerie Miles. Jim Gardner and Margaret Gardner. Anthony Napolitano and Jamie Napolitano. Tom Tunney and Illinois State Representative Sarah Fagenholtz. David Moore and Elizabeth Lee. Stephanie Coleman and retired Alderman Shirley A. Coleman. Nicholas Spizzato.
And James Irvin
and Mrs. Thelma Irvin. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to introduce you to our special guests and kindly hold your applause until all the guests have reached their seats. Please welcome Mr. Mark Flessner, Corporation Council appointee for the City of Chicago, the Honorable Kim Fox, Cook County State's Attorney. The Honorable Edward Moody, Cook County Recorder of Deeds. The Honorable Karen Yarborough, Clerk of Cook County. The Honorable Dorothy Brown, Clerk of the Circuit Court of Cook County. The Honorable Fritz Kagan, Cook County Assessor. The Honorable Tony Preckwinkle, Cook County Board President. Ms. Kathy Byrne. The Honorable David Orr. The Honorable John Cullerton, President of the Illinois State Senate. The Honorable Susana Mendoza, Comptroller of the State of Illinois. The Honorable Jesse White, Secretary of State of Illinois. The Honorable Kwame Raoul, Attorney General for the State of Illinois. The Honorable Juliana Stratton, Lieutenant Governor of Illinois. The Honorable Bobby Rush, First Congressional District of Illinois. The Honorable Robin Kelly, Second Congressional District of Illinois. The Honorable Jesus Chuy Garcia, Fourth Congressional District of Illinois. The Honorable Richard M. Daley and Ms. Nora Daley. Reverend Dr. L. Bernard Jakes. Imam Tariq L. Amin. Reverend Dr. Beth Brown. Rabbi Capers Funye Jr. Father Thomas J. Hurley. The Honorable Mary C. Marubio. The Honorable P. Scott Neville Jr. The Honorable Susan E. Cox.
And now, ladies and gentlemen,
Governor of the State of Illinois, J.B. Pritzker, and First Lady M.K. Pritzker.
Ladies and gentlemen,
United States Senator of the State of Illinois, the Honorable Tammy Duckworth.
Ladies and gentlemen,
United States Senator of the State of Illinois, the Honorable Richard Durbin.
Ladies and gentlemen,
the Honorable Anna Valencia and Mr. Rayed Kazmi.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Treasurer-elect Melissa Conyers-Irvin and Mrs. Eula Conyers.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Mayor of the City of Chicago, Rahm Emanuel and Ms. Amy Rule.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Mayor-elect of the City of Chicago, Lori E. Lightfoot, Ms. Amy Eshelman, and Vivian Lightfoot.
The council will come to order.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the posting of the colors by the Phoenix Military Academy Junior Reserve Officers Training Corps. Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance, led by Arturo Ballesteros.
I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for the national anthem, which will be sung by Miguel Cervantes, accompanied by the Chicago Sinfonietta. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
The invocation will be delivered by Reverend Dr. Bernard Jakes.
I respectfully ask that each of us would pause for a moment as we seek guidance and blessings for this respected occasion. Creator of all that have gathered in this place, it is with great joy that we gather to celebrate the new possibilities that await our city. As we have gathered as a beloved community, We ask that your presence be manifested in this celebration. The people of the city have elected Lori Lightfoot, Anna Valencia, Melissa Conyers Irvin, and this beautiful bouquet of alder women and men to lead us. We pray you affirm their election with your blessing on this day. We are grateful for your allowing us to participate in the democracy of electing officials, but we also acknowledge this allowance as your actions of favor, grace, and love to and for your human creation. Most beloved creator of all, as your presence has turned this arena into a place of radical encounter, because you are a God of justice and love, we petition you to grant that same spirit of justice and love to our new mayor, as she prepares to lead our city. Grant Lori the ability to imitate you. Grant her wisdom to make the right decisions. Give her power to lead justly. Inspire her to walk humbly. Protect her when others attack her, and love her even more strongly when others may show insensitivity toward her. We pray your grace keeps her, your mercy covers her, and your love protects her, Amy and Vivian, as they begin this new journey as our first family. Our blessed Creator, as we are gathered in this place, teach us to walk gently with our elected servants as a beloved community. Guide us as we seek justice together, make peace together, walk in hope together. May the words of Dr. Howard Thurman come alive in both elected officials and people. Don't ask what the world needs. Ask what makes you come alive and go do it. Because what the world needs are people who have come alive. And as an alive people, we welcome and receive your presence of love as we begin this journey anew. With grateful and excited hearts, we pray. Amen.
Please welcome Alfreda Burke and Roderick Dixon, accompanied by Fred Nelson III.
The story, let it echo far and wide, make them hear you, make them hear you.
How justice was our battle.
Yeah.
them hear you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the prayer for guidance will be delivered by Imam Tariq El Amin.
May the peace that only God can give be upon each and every one of you. We pray in the name of the all-seeing, the all-hearing, the ever-merciful creator of the heavens and the earth, with God's name, the merciful benefactor, the merciful redeemer. All praise is due to God, Lord, cherisher and sustainer of all the systems of knowledge, the merciful benefactor, the merciful redeemer, the sole judge on the day of judgment. You alone do we worship, and your aid alone do we seek. Show us the straight way, the way of those upon whom you have bestowed your grace, not the way of those who have incurred your wrath, nor those who go astray. We pray for the guidance and protection of those elected to serve the city of Chicago. We pray that as they take the oath to uphold the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of Illinois, that you keep these women and men mindful of their own internal constitution. We pray that you keep them upright and unbent. We pray that you strengthen them as only you can. Let them stand firmly for peace. Let them stand firmly for justice. Let them stand firmly for equity, no matter who stands on the other side. Protect their eyes from blindness. Let them see the people. Protect their ears from deafness. Let them hear the people. Protect their tongues from meaningless speech. Let them speak directly to the people. Protect their hearts from the bitter winds of cynicism. Keep their hearts softened towards the people. Dear God, guide them and give them success in their endeavor to lead through service, because their success is our success. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, Chicago City Clerk Anna Valencia.
I, Andrea,
Marie Valencia.
I, Andrea Marie Valencia.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
Of the office of Clerk of the City of Chicago.
Of the office of Clerk of the City of Chicago.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
My chairing section, thank you.
Will the alderman-elect of the 50 wards please rise and please raise your right hand and repeat after me.
I state your name.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of Illinois,
and that I will faithfully discharge the duties
of the office of Alderman of the City of Chicago.
According to the best of my ability.
Congratulations, Alderman and Alderwomen.
Alderman, please be seated.
Who said that?
The clerk will call the roll.
Alderman David LaSpada.
Alderman Brian Hopkins.
Alderman Pat Dow.
Alderman Sophia King.
Alderman Leslie Harrison.
Alderman Roderick Sawyer.
Alderman Gregory Mitchell.
Alderman Michelle Harris.
Alderman Anthony Beal.
Alderman Susan Zalowski Garza.
Alderman Patrick Daly.
Alderman George Cardenas.
Alderman Marty Quinn.
Alderman Edward Burke.
Alderman Raymond Lopez.
Alderman Stephanie Coleman.
Alderman David Moore.
Alderman Derek Curtis.
Alderman Matthew O'Shea.
Alderman Jeanette Taylor.
Alderman Howard Brookins Jr.
Alderman Michael Rodriguez.
Alderman Savannah Tabares.
Alderman Michael Scott Jr.
Alderman Byron Cicho Lopez.
Alderman Roberto Maldonado.
Alderman Walter Burnett Jr.
Alderman Jason Irvin.
Alderman Chris Talaferro.
Alderman Ariel Reboyes.
Alderman Felix Cardona.
Alderman Scott Wagaspak.
Alderman Rosanna Rodriguez Sanchez.
Alderman Carrie Austin.
Alderman Carlos Ramirez Rosa.
Alderman Gilbert Villegas.
Alderman Emma Mitz.
Alderman Nicholas Posado.
Alderman Samantha Nugent.
Alderman Andre Vasquez.
Alderman Anthony Napolitano.
Alderman Brendan Riley.
Alderman Michelle Smith.
Alderman Tom Tunney.
Alderman Jim Gardner.
Alderman James Kappelman.
Alderman Matt Martin.
Alderman
Harry Osterman.
Alderman
Maria Haddon.
Alderman
Deborah Silverstein. Your Honor, we have a quorum present.
We have a quorum.
We have a quorum.
I now present to you for your consideration the official bonds of the Honorable Lori E. Lightfoot as Mayor of the City of Chicago, the Honorable Anna Valencia as the City Clerk of Chicago, and the Honorable Melissa Conyers Irvin as a Treasurer of the City of Chicago, which have been certified as to form by the Corporation Council and certified as the sutures by the City Comptroller.
Alderman O'Shea for a motion on the bonds.
Mr. President, I move that the City Council do approve the bonds for the mayor, clerk, and treasurer.
On Alderman O'Shea's motion to approve the bonds, all those in favor say aye. Those opposed say no. The ayes have it, and the bonds are approved.
Mayor Emanuel, Mayor-elect Lightfoot, Treasurer-elect Conyers Irvin, members of the City Council, the Clerk of Cook County has filed in the Office of the City Clerk the official statements of election for the offices of Mayor, City Clerk, City Treasurer, and Alderman of the 50 wards of the City of Chicago.
And now, the prayer for peace to be delivered by Reverend Dr. Beth Brown.
Good morning, Chicago! I am so excited to be here with you today as we make history. As I lead us in prayer, I want to invite you to participate in a part of the prayer which is call and response. I'll let you know when it's time. It means you have to pay attention. Let us join together in prayer. God of many names, tribes, cultures, and planets, we are here today in this place to pray for peace for our city. But what is peace? There are some among us who would settle for the absence of war or violence or conflict. But you do not want us to settle there. In the Hebrew scriptures, we have a vision of peace as shalom or wholeness or well-being. In the Greek scriptures, we have a vision of peace as joining or binding together that which has been separated or those who have been separated or divided. These two visions together lead us to a peace that includes wholeness and well-being and joining together and the ability to thrive for all people. Today and every day going forward, we pray to you for this peace for our city and for every person and every living thing in it. All of our major religions teach that we should do to others what we want them to do to us, and we should refrain from doing to others what we don't want them to do to us. These words are pathways to peace. We are here today to celebrate a new day in Chicago. We are grateful for our newly elected officials and for their willingness to serve in leadership at this time. As we make history today by inaugurating Lori Lightfoot as mayor, help us to seize this moment to be and to create the kind of change we want to see going forward. At this critical juncture in our city, we claim what we know to be true. We are enough, and we have enough. In every neighborhood and ward, we have people with the gifts that we need to bring us together. Across this city, from the south to the north, from the west to the east, we have an abundance of wealth, knowledge, talent, creativity, persistence, understanding, generosity, and compassion. What keeps us from building and walking the road to peace is that we get stuck in scarcity thinking. Time and time again, we act as if there is great scarcity. There is not enough for everyone. This prayer for peace is a call for us to live the truth of our abundance. Deepen in all of us the desire to create a Chicago where there is room enough for everyone. Food enough for everyone. Voice enough for everyone. Resources enough for everyone. Opportunities enough for everyone. We heard throughout the campaign from our new mayor that as a city, we are better together. Being better together means no one gets left behind. In this prayer, let's practice being better together. As I pray about the work we have to do, I will end each thought by asking, how? And you respond by saying, we are enough and we have enough. Let's hear it. We are enough and we have enough. God, just as we did on April 2nd, help us to wage peace by literally joining hands with people we don't even know across our great city. How? We are enough and we have enough. Help us to wage peace by recognizing that every child in this city is our child. How? We are enough, and we have enough. Help us to wage peace by including and not excluding, and by refusing to leave a single person behind. How? We are enough, and we have enough. Help us to wage peace by not playing small, and by realizing that each one of us has gifts to bring and to offer our city. How? We are enough and we have enough. Help us to wage peace by our commitment to creating one city where we truly are better together. How? We are enough and we have enough. This prayer for peace is audacious, O God, and will require every one of us to become, in the words of the prophet Isaiah, repairers of the breach and restorers of the streets to live in. We must repair our city because of the historical and the current gaps. There is no peace that is an easy peace. And we will not settle for a false peace. Because we are enough and we have enough, we pray for nothing less than transformation. As we repair our city and restore our streets, transform us and transform our city, we pray, so that together we will let our light shine. Amen.
The Honorable P. Scott Neville, Jr., Supreme Court Justice, First District of the Illinois Supreme Court, will now administer the oath of office to Melissa Conyers Irvin as Treasurer of the City of Chicago.
Where?
Stood on my side in this early.
Thank you. Come on, baby. Stand right there and hold it for a moment.
Please, please place your hand on the Bible and raise your right hand. And repeat after me.
Melissa Conyers Irvin.
Do
solemnly swear
that I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And the Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the Office of Treasurer.
The duties of the Office of Treasurer.
Of the City of Chicago.
Of the City of Chicago.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
Congratulations, you've been installed.
Thank you. Thank
you.
You
did a tremendous job. Congratulations, all of you.
Wait a minute, baby.
Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, please bow your heads for the blessing to be delivered by Rabbi Capers C. Fournier, Jr.
Let us pray.
Let us pray.
Avinu Hashemayim,
our Father in heaven,
we come into your presence today
on this most auspicious occasion.
To ask for your guidance
and blessing upon this administration
and our Mayor Lori Lightfoot.
As we move from the season of Passover
to this 30th day of the counting of the Omer
and the receiving of the Torah,
we are mindful
that we have left behind recently the Easter season,
and we enter into the holy season of Ramadan.
May your blessings flow from heaven
upon all faiths
in our city of Chicago community.
Our community.
We are one community.
As long as we stand united,
we can overcome all obstacles.
So I say to our communities
from the west side,
the south side,
the near north side,
to the far north side,
to let us stand united behind our mayor.
For the sages of the Talmud have said,
if I am not for myself,
who will be for me?
And if I am only for myself,
what am I?
And if not now,
when?
This threefold dictum
refers to man's spiritual goals.
This teaches us
that if I do not rouse my soul to higher things,
who will rouse it?
If I do not fulfill the commandments,
who will fulfill them for me?
If I am not for myself,
even
I
make success
efforts to grow spiritually.
There is still so much more for me to do.
Consequently,
I can never be satisfied with myself.
Some comment that although man must work hard to perfect himself,
he must not forget
that he is a part of a group,
a community
that both helps him
or her
and should share in her accomplishments.
So our prayer today
is that we stand united as one community.
One city,
as we go forward from strength to strength,
May you bless our mayor, Lori Lightfoot,
with wisdom,
with understanding,
with patience,
and with unity
in every community.
Our God,
and the God of our forefathers,
bless us with the three-verse blessing
in the Torah that was written by the hand of Moshe,
your servant,
that was said by Aharon and his sons,
the Kohanim,
your holy people.
And it is said,
May the Lord bless you and keep you.
May the Lord illuminate his countenance for you and be gracious to you.
May the Lord turn his countenance to you
and establish peace for you.
And let us say, Amen.
The Honorable Susan E. Cox, Magistrate Judge for the U.S. District Court for the Northern District of Illinois, will now administer the oath of office to Lori E. Lightfoot as Mayor of the City of Chicago.
Hand on the Bible. Right hand.
I, Lori Elaine Lightfoot, do solemnly swear
that I will support the Constitution of the United States
and the Constitution of the State of Illinois
and that I will faithfully discharge the duties
of the office of mayor
of the city of Chicago
according to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you so very much.
As I stand as your mayor,
humble and hopeful,
honored to be the 56th mayor of this great city.
We are a proud city with a proud history.
In this moment,
I can't help but look at all of you and think about what lies ahead and what we can be together.
I'm looking ahead to a city of safe streets and strong schools for every child, regardless of neighborhood or zip code.
A city where people want to grow old and not flee.
A city of sanctuary against fear, where no one must hide in the shadows.
A city that is affordable for families and seniors, and where every job pays a living wage.
A city of fairness and hope and prosperity for many,
not just for the few.
A city that holds equity and inclusion as our guiding principles.
Chicago is not where my story began,
but from the moment that I arrived in Hyde Park to attend law school and begin my career.
This is the city where I belonged.
It's where I met the love of my life, my wife Amy.
It's where our daughter Vivian was born,
and she's growing up to be
into the kind, curious, and spirited young woman that I always knew she would be.
For me, this city has given me such opportunity.
It's been a city of hope.
As I stand here today,
I can't help but think about where I came from.
And I know in my heart that a story like mine of a kid growing up in a working class family,
growing up to realize the dreams of my father and my mother
through education, hard work, and sheer determination, needs to be the story of possibility in every neighborhood. Children who look like me and come from families like mine shouldn't have to beat the odds to get education, pursue their passions, or build a family. Black and brown kids, low income kids, every kid in this city should grow up knowing they can pursue anything.
They can love anyone.
That's my Chicago dream. I know we're just a little bit closer to that dream as I stand here today, inaugurated as Chicago's first black woman mayor and first openly gay mayor. A little bit closer as we celebrate that for the first time in the history of Chicago, women of color now hold all three citywide elected offices. I congratulate you, City Clerk Anna Valencia, and City Treasurer Melissa Conyers Irvin, on your inaugurations, your victories, and all you've done to overcome to reach this historic moment. I also congratulate the aldermen of the Chicago City Council, in particular the 12 aldermen who are taking their seats for the first time. Let's give them a round of applause. I thank Mayor Emanuel for his dedication and service to this city, which was exemplified by the attention and time that he and his staff devoted to making this transition as smooth as possible. And I also commend Amy Rule for her contributions to the city. Join me in wishing them both well as they head off into the next chapter of their lives. I also want to acknowledge and thank the other leaders here today. Governor J.B. Pritzker, Lieutenant Governor Juliana Stratton, Senator Dick Durbin, Senator Tammy Duckworth, and our Illinois Congressional Delegation, Cook County Board President Tony Preckwinkle, representatives from our state legislature, and every other elected official here today. Thank you for your continued service. Most importantly, though, I want to thank the people of Chicago who had the courage to put their faith in a newcomer and the optimism to join this moment. We stand today at a time of great hope and possibility. I can't help but feel the spirit of the great late Mayor Harold Washington here with us this morning. That you are about to meet, who laid the foundation for everything that I am today. I want to introduce you to a former elected official with us, a one-time school board member from my hometown of Massillon.
She's my role model, my champion.
Woman on whose dreams and high expectations propelled me through life. My mother. My mom is 9 years old, and forgive me for disclosing that, and doesn't travel much these days, but nothing could keep her or my siblings, Derek, Angela, Brian, and Stacy, from being here today. My mother and my late father, Elijah, gave us the best they could in the town that we grew up in, even when they had almost nothing else to give. As parents, they led by example. They instilled in me a clear set of values, loyalty to family, friends and community, and the importance of hard work, education, and integrity. And Mom, most importantly, you and Dad told me that I could be anything that I wanted to be. That I could not be held back by my race, gender, or family financial status. That I should hold my head up high and not let anyone else dictate my destiny or my future. That no goal was out of reach, that no victory was too unlikely to pursue. I feel my father's presence here today. My gratitude to you both has no limit. Just like when I was a little girl, I'm working hard to make you proud, to honor your sacrifice, to live by the values you instilled in me, to make sure that families like ours don't have to struggle like we did. I look out today and I see a proud city with a proud history. Here in Chicago, right here, our people invented the skyscraper and the Ferris wheel. Here, our people invented our own Chicago blues. Our people. Generations of industrious, hardworking people who built one of the greatest cities ever to grace God's earth. And I stand here today as your mayor, humble and hopeful, and I make one solemn promise to the generations who came before us and to the generations yet to come. We will continue to build this great city and leave it better, stronger, fairer, or more prosperous than when we found it. The challenges we face today did not arise overnight, and they will not be solved overnight. But they certainly won't be saved and solved by one mayor acting alone. In this important moment, let us remember the powerful words of Chicago's poet laureate, Gwendolyn Brooks. She said, we are each other's harvest. We are each other's business, and we are each other's magnitude and bond. Folks, we must be in this together. Our challenges can only be solved if we face them together. We cannot fail. We will not fail. We are Chicago. I also remember so many people I met in the city who can't be here today, who will never see the inside of a room like this. The big guy who came to hear me speak and then followed me outside on a cold, blustery day on the southeast side and pleaded, Lori, just bring us jobs. Just bring us jobs. We want to work. The teenagers that I met on the south side, kicked out of their homes and left on the streets at night in the bitter cold with no food or shelter just because they were gay or trans. The father on the west side who told me he was scared, scared to death every time his three daughters left the house. Those girls are his whole world, and he's worried somebody's going to gun them down. The countless number of people whose daily fear is that ICE would come for them as they took their kids to school, stood as day laborers, or just walked in their neighborhoods. We should never forget that these are the people who put us here. We are each other's business, and standing up for them is our business, our only business. Now, there are four stars on Chicago's flag, each standing for a point in our history. The construction of Fort Dearborn, the great expositions of 1893 and 1933, and the reconstruction of our city following the Great Fire. Each star stands for building and rebuilding. Today, we should proudly reinterpret these four stars with new meaning for a new century, with new challenges and opportunities that lie ahead, guiding our city and guiding our new administration as we move forward and rebuild again. Today, we reimagine the first star standing for safety in every neighborhood. People cannot and should not live in neighborhoods that resemble a war zone. Enough of the shootings, enough of the guns, enough of the violence. Let's unite in our response to the biggest challenge we face, the epidemic of gun violence that devastates families, shatters communities, buries dreams, and holds children hostage in their homes for fear. It inflicts lifelong trauma that spreads through our communities like a virus. When we hear a random bullet cutting a life short, people across the city from all ages and walks of life begin to wonder if Chicago is a place where they can continue to live and raise their children. Some have already answered the question by moving away, particularly from the hardest hit communities. The mass exodus that we have seen, particularly in the black community, saps the vitality of our great city. We must reverse the exodus by creating the reality of safety in every neighborhood. Public safety must not be a commodity that is only available to the wealthy. What this means for me is that there is no higher calling than restoring safety and peace in our neighborhoods. We will develop a new proactive strategy in partnership with the communities hardest hit by the scourge of gun violence. All of our stakeholders must be committed to this work. Now, this is not a challenge that can be solved by law enforcement alone, nor will we place the blame on communities, on people and communities who are under siege. No, this greatest challenge demands all of us united together, and I promise you, the city will lead, and we've already begun this work. To lead the citywide response, we are creating a mayor's office of public safety to be led by a deputy mayor. That office will be charged with developing and implementing a comprehensive violence prevention strategy that will connect efforts across city government, all us other aspects of the private sector, nonprofit, philanthropic, education, recreation, and business and faith communities. It will seek to mobilize the entire city in a unifying strategy to prevent violence and promote public safety. And while we will specifically address the gun violence, we will not limit our efforts there. The devastation of violence is far and wide, which is why we will reach out and support the growing community of victims and witnesses. We must recognize the importance of providing transition for our returning citizens, and we will accelerate the development of a trauma-informed city, starting with repairing our broken mental health safety net. We will also also continue the hard but essential work of forging partnerships between the police officers and the communities, premised upon mutual respect, accountability, and a recognition that the destinies of police and community are inextricably combined. One cannot concede without the other. And to all of our brave first responders, we will not leave you behind either. You deserve our respect, and not only that, but our commitment to train you better, provide you the best quality supervision and wellness support to address the trauma that you face every day. These are essential pieces of police reform and accountability. We are each other's business. We are each other's neighbors. And together, we will work tirelessly to bring peace to this city. Our second guiding star is education. We cannot attract families to Chicago and keep families here without providing a quality public education. And that means for every child, every single child. As a city, we make promises to our children. Most of all, we promise them an education, a safe, relevant, and challenging education that prepares them for meaningful work, civic engagement, and lifelong learning. But whether we deliver on that promise often depends on where you happen to live. It's time to give every child and young person a good education to prove them through our schools that we believe in them, that we support them no matter who they are or where they live. Every child gets a quality education. That's our business no matter what. Someone said to me recently that children are the product of the adult ecosystem around them, and she was 100% right. Our words, our values, how we make commitments and rise to the occasion, it all matters. We're shaping the future leaders of our city. And when we put equity first in our education system, would we make good on the promise that every kid matters? It will instill within our children the values we seek to foster as an entire city. That promise must begin early. That's why we will work to expand early childhood education and extend the promise of a good education through high school and college and to every kid, no matter their path forward. Every student should have the option to pursue vocational and technical training. We will work with businesses and our friends in labor to set up apprenticeships for those who want to learn a trade. We will then connect Chicago's employers with our job-ready students while they're in school so that they can graduate and get to work the day they graduate. And we will support our great teachers, counselors, librarians, nurses, and other support personnel who are essential to creating the safe and nurturing environment necessary for our children to grow and learn and thrive. And let me also say I'm thrilled to see so many young people in the audience. And my next few words are for you and your peers all across the city. You have the most at stake in the city's future. Just as the city's future most depends on you. We need your energy, your creativity, intelligence, and dedication. There's hard work ahead of us, but we will do that work because we believe in you and in the vast, still untapped potential of this great city. Our goal is simple. Starting in schools, will we create a citywide workforce as a pipeline for the jobs of today and tomorrow that will be the envy of the world? We are each other's business, and we must meet our educational challenges together. The third of our guiding stars is stability. To be true to the notion of stability, we must get our fiscal house in order. Over many years, Chicago dug itself into a giant financial hole. We have outsized structural deficit, a persistent and growing pension debt, and other costs that threaten our financial stability. We are spending a significant percentage of every dollar just to service our pension debt. And that alone means that money that should be sent elsewhere is being sent to banks and bond firms instead of being sent to rebuild our neighborhoods, reduce our property taxes, and revitalize our transportation system. We must tackle this problem head on. My team has already been doing the necessary work of measuring the size and depth of our fiscal challenges, as well as a range of possible solutions. Once that analysis is complete, we will lay out a plan to put Chicago on the path to solvency. No doubt, some hard choices will have to be made, and none of this is going to be easy. But we will do the hard work with transparency, integrity, and a determination to put our pensions on a path of true solvency and make our government work more efficiently without balancing our budgets on the backs of working class and poor families in Chicago. And we will get there because we must. Stability also means that we must build housing that is affordable for more people, including families. Long-term residents, whether they're homeowners or renters, should not be forced out of their neighborhoods when it goes through a period of transformation. And developers can no longer skip their responsibilities by taking tax dollars, but leaving it to someone else to solve our affordable housing crisis. Here, too, our city must lead. We must cut the red tape and obstacles and instead promote the building of new units and have flexibilities in our building code so that innovative housing forms can come online. We must also have a plan for expanding home ownership and converting vacant lots and abandoned buildings into new, vibrant communities. Growth of housing that is affordable all over this city will be the charge of the new housing department under new leadership. Stability also means support for our business community, large and small. Strong businesses, growing businesses, new businesses means jobs and stability for the city. We need fairness, which means paying as much attention to our neighborhood businesses as we do to the downtown. Our neighborhoods have been neglected for too long. They cannot be anymore. Still, we should never settle for dividing up a shrinking pie or pitting one part of the city against the other. Chicago is the economic engine of Illinois and the whole Midwest. And with everything, we are each other's business. We need to grow and grow and grow together. Now our four-star must be integrity.
I know.
Putting Chicago government and integrity in the same sentence sometimes may seem a little strange.
But friends,
that's going to change
because it's got to change.
For years, they've said Chicago ain't ready for reform.
Well, get ready
because reform is here. Change, and I plan to deliver change to our government. That means restoring trust in our city's government and finally bringing some real integrity to the way this city works. It means making sure we have a government that actually works for people, not a powerful few.
It's about the harm done to our families and businesses when those with power and money, cash,
cash in at our expense. When public officials cut shady backroom deals, they get rich, and the rest of us get the bill. When some people get their property taxes cut in exchange for campaign cash, they get the money, and sure enough, we get the bill. The family with the bungalow, the lady who runs the hair salon, the guy who owns the store on the corner. They aren't powerful or big or well-connected, but they end up paying when our government is corrupt. These practices have gone on for far too long, and this practice breeds corruption. Stopping it isn't just in the city's interest, it's in the city council's interest. No official in the city of Chicago, elected or appointed, should ever profit from his office. Never, ever. The requirement that people must give more to access basic city services must end. And it will, starting today. Later this afternoon, I will sign an executive order to end the worst abuses of the so-called aldermanic privilege. This does not mean that our aldermen won't have power in their communities. Of course they will. And it does not mean that our aldermen will not be able to make sure that the streetlights are working or the parking signs are in the right place or any of the thousands of good things that they do for people every day. It simply means this. It means ending their unilateral, unchecked control over every single thing that goes on in their wards. Will have a voice, but not a veto. It's the time for a new era of trust between the people of Chicago and the government that serves them. When our poet said, "We are each other's bonds," this is exactly what she meant. Now, as I stand here today, Georgia is also on my mind, as is Alabama and every other state that is enacting laws intended to deprive women of their rights. We must stand with women all across our country who fear for their basic rights and feel powerless in the face of hateful legislation designed to control our bodies and our choices. We cannot go back, not in Chicago, not in our nation. We will join together and we will fight. Now there's something else that we must do for ourselves and our posterity. We will establish a new social compact here in Chicago based on the simple principle shared by every major religion in the world. It goes by many names. In Buddhism, it says, hurt not others in ways that you hurt yourself. that you yourself would find hurtful. In the Quran it says, whoever saves a life, it is as though he had saved all mankind. It's in the Torah and in the New Testament, and it's called the Great Commandment. Love thy neighbor as thyself. Today, too many of our people lack decent housing, and far too many end up in our streets. Today, too many of our people feel isolated and alone. And our senior population increases. We must meet their needs for those who have no family or friends for support. Today, as we prepare to enter the third decade of the 21st century, one out of every five children lives in poverty. I'm going to repeat that. One out of every five children lives in poverty. Addressing the problems of housing, isolation, and poverty in this great city is just as important as anything else we may do, and far harder to solve. But tackle these problems we must. I heard a century-old hymn in church the other day. A song that I know from my youth of so many Sundays, sitting in church, listening to the working class people in my congregation who toil in factories, in kitchens, or outside, and came to church for a respite from their very hard days. We sang this song. Pass me not, O gentle Savior. Hear my humble cry. While on others thou art calling, do not pass me by. In that moment, it was our plea to God to shine his light on us and relieve us from the heavy labors. As I reflect on this day and what lies ahead, it means to me that we must not forget or ignore the plight of so many for whom joy does not come in the morning. Whether it is the homeless, people living with mental illness, those desperate for love and recognition, we will not pass them by. As we pursue our new stars, this will be our guiding light. To those who are alone, we are with you. For those who need a home, we will shelter you. And for those who have little, we will do much. We see you. We hear you. We are your neighbors. And so help me, God, we will not pass you by. I stand before you, representing tens of thousands of people all over this city who daily contribute their time, their talent, their resources in the cause of making a difference, not just today, but if we are bold, our collective efforts will resonate for years to come. Our people, friends and neighbors, known and unknown, at the block level, in our places of worship, in community organizations, and just individuals who want to make a difference have stepped up and contributed mightily to what is the greatness of this city. I will have the privilege of leading, but clearly a single leader cannot heal all that ails us. A single leader cannot by herself conquer all the challenges that will be present on this day and every day forward. We all have to be part of the solution. We must make the sacrifices necessary to identify problems and to forge solutions. And my friends, we must not merely rely upon the politicians, the preachers, the police, the teachers, the activists to show us the way. We can no longer continue to concede our control of our destiny to someone else. Each of us needs to ask, what can I do? What contributions can I make? You may not be the richest, you may not be the smartest, or even the most able, but ask yourself, are you ready to serve? Because your city surely needs you. What has been the most humbling and amazing part of this journey is the tremendous hope and optimism that I'm feeling from people all over this city. My friends, it is this message of hope and possibility that should get us up in the morning, start us on our way, and bring us together with the excitement and the promise born of harnessing our collective energies to move forward. Our challenges are great, there's no mistaking that. But if we follow our four stars, safety, education, stability, and integrity, we can once again become a city that families want to move to, not run away from. No matter who you are, no matter where you live, no matter your circumstance in life, Chicago is now on a mission to join hands with you, to share power with you, and to give you the reason to believe that we can all pull in the same direction to make Chicago better together. And if we follow the great commandment together as neighbors, our great city will shine.
God bless you.
God bless you. And God bless this great city of Chicago. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy a musical selection by Liz Wright, accompanied by Kenny Banks.
Thank you.
bow your heads for the benediction to be delivered by Father Thomas J. Hurley.
Thank you. I feel like I'm at a Catholic church after communion, and they're all leaving early. But in that spirit, let us pray. Holy God, whose name we praise and whose presence we now acknowledge, through the blessing of our diversity, you, O God, are expressed in so many ways. Through so many cultures and peoples, religious traditions and practice, it has been our joy and our pleasure to be gathered together today to celebrate the richness of Chicago. We are proud of our city, and we give thanks to you, O God, for entrusting this part of your world to all of us. As we have celebrated these proceedings in this gathering today, and we've welcomed our new mayor, Lori Lightfoot, and other members of our city government, Now it's time, Lord, for us literally to go back to work. Send us forth, O God, with a renewed energy and a reinvigorated purpose to bring about nothing but goodness in the lives of our citizens among all the many neighborhoods that make up this great city. Whether we live on the south, the north, the east, or the west sides, Whether we identify with the White Sox or the Cubs, whether we take the blue or the purple or the green or the brown or the red or the orange lines, whether we identify as Christian or Jewish or Muslim or Buddhist, or perhaps we struggle with faith, whether we speak Spanish or English or any other language that represents the world community, no matter what the distinctions are made that give us our identity, Just please, O God, put us all on the right path to build up a welcoming, peaceful, healthy, and holy city as you would want it. Give wisdom and strength to Lori and all those in the city council. May they work together for the common good of Chicago and discern well the choices and decisions to keep making our metropolitan area a world-class city. And as we heard from the Reverend Brown, we are better together. So then, O God, keep us united and help us all to avoid the trappings that often divide us. As you send us forth now from this gathering, help us to remember every citizen of this great city that we all share in the responsibility of caring for it, our home, with Lori and our new leaders, and the aldermen and the aldermen of our 50 great geographic wards, may we all pledge to care for one another with respect, reverence, and understanding.
Guide us, strengthen us, encourage us, protect us, and love us.
For you are God who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Alderman Villegas.
Motion to recess.
I move that the City Council stand in recess until Wednesday, May 29th, 10 a.m. in the City Council chambers of City Hall.
Alderman Villegas has moved that the City Council stand in recess. All those in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed say no.
The ayes have it,
and the City Council hereby stands in recess until Wednesday, May 29th, 2019, at 10 a.m.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your attendance here today. This concludes the 2019 inauguration ceremony for the legislators and executive officers of the City of Chicago. Please enjoy the bagpipes and drums of the Emerald Society of the Chicago Police Department, followed by the Chicago Sinfonietta as you exit the arena, and have a great Chicago Day!